She won't speak. She's mute.
What appealed to me most about the story was that there was this very, very strong female protagonist. I loved the idea of what she, who she was and what she had to do, really. So actually, we're quite familiar in theatre with Hedda Gabler and Nora, and then various adaptations of Thérèse Raquin and Emma Bovary. These women who sort of either kill themselves or they run away or suffer in silence. And with Catherine, what I found to be thrilling was the sense that she actually fights back. She doesn't do any of those things that we had seen before. Because the setup is quite conventional. A young woman trapped in a loveless marriage who then starts to have an affair. We've seen that several times in work from this period, literature of this period. But with Catherine, she's so proactive and so bloody and so passionate that I thought we have to, you know, adapt this to the screen.
Do you love me?
Of course.
Do you adore me?
Of course.
Could you do without me? Could you do without me? It's husbands and wives that kiss like that.
I knew that people like period dramas. I mean, I watch a lot of period dramas. The British in particular feel like it is in their DNA, that we export a lot of British period dramas around the world. And so we knew that there would be an audience. But what we wanted was to challenge the audience by saying, here is a different sort of period drama, one that you might enjoy, one that might challenge you.
You know I shan't be parted from your life, Sebastian. Through hell and high water, I will follow you. To the cross, to the prison, to the grave, to the sky.